I'm starting concept work on a Halo miniature wargame, and I need some good-looking Covenant bases. So I've made these as my first try. I think this is a good base to work off, but it needs some more iterations. I started with these lip bases and sanded them smooth at the bottom. You can find these files in the description below. I really liked the lip top, because it means texture that you put in lays flush. I give them all a spray of matte primer and get to work with texturing. For the texture, I originally was going to use air dry clay. However, I ended up swapping over to Milliput because it's a lot easier to work with and dries a bit harder. For coming up with ideas for textures, I booted up MCC and took some screenshots from different Covenant ships in the game. At this point, I was really set on an idea of that hexagon pattern, as well as some smooth and alien looking shapes that would be like walls or skirting along the ground. I don't know what it's meant to be, but it adds a lot of variety and texture to it and really makes it look more Covenant. So I started by filling up the lip of the base with a bunch of Milliput and pressing it flat against the table. This gave me a good base to then press in some texture. And for that texture, I just used this phone case that I also 3D printed and cut up a bit. This hexagon phone case is really good as just a stamp and comes out looking really perfect. I even used the stamp on some flat pieces of the Milliput that I just stamped down and then cut out. And this is just another way to go about filling up that hole that is caused by the lip in the base. And you can see when those dry, they're really easy just to slot in to the base. I tried many different textures, but I'm really happy with how the hexagons came out. So this is what I'm going to use for the floor of my bases. I then rolled out some Milliput and started building those little lips along the ground that will eventually become purple. Now this, doing it with Milliput, was kind of difficult, but in the same time it was kind of rewarding and good as well. The more effort and work you put into it, the cooler looking shapes and the more realistic or natural it's going to look. Once the Milliput had hardened, I gave them a spray of the same primer and got to painting them. For the hexagon floor, I mixed together a black wash and a grey paint, which gave me this like semi-translucent dark grey. And then for the other piece, I used a heavy violet from Vallejo. Once they had dried, I also give them a black wash over both parts. That way, when I come through with a shifting metallic, also from Vallejo, onto that purple, it shines a bit better because it's meant to go over black. And for the miniatures, I just gave them a Zenithal highlight and painted them with Army Painter's speed paints. And I can't wait to have an army of these guys. I just need the game to go with it. If you have any ideas, leave it down in the comment section below. And as always, I'll see you next week with something different.
Silenced.